Next, we'll talk about ABBYY FlexiCapture verification. We'll talk about verification stages, tasks, and queues, various data verification settings, and we'll talk about the web verification station as well. Here are the five default queues for verification. We start with the data verification, then we have the verification queue, and those are the most commonly used verification stages. So oftentimes there's a bifurcation of verification where first data verification happens and someone knocks out and adjudicates all low confidence characters and some of the rule violations as well. Once that gets knocked out, a different employee, perhaps a knowledge worker, as opposed to a very fast data entry clerk, sees a batch and everything's at 100% in terms of low confidence characters. However, there still may be and will be more complex rule violations to check and adjudicate. So this split verification process can be very, very effective in using people's time most efficiently. So then we have the document assembly check, and the document assembly check is actually very important if you've got a lot of multi-page document checks to do. That, however, can be done in the verification stage. The batch integrity check queue relies on a batch integrity script to be written, and so that's used less frequently. And export confirmation happens right before final export. And that can be useful when you're getting a project started. But my personal opinion is it's a better idea to get a lot of the rules in place and the format checks in place so that you really don't need to take a close look at images before they're exported for a final time. FlexiCapture is a batch-driven system. So when images are ingested, they come through as batches. If you've got a very, very large batch, it's automatically broken up into tasks. So no one has to sit down and verify 2,000 pages or something like that. So you can also manually create tasks or set the task threshold. This is an important slide. By default, there's a setting that's not turned on, and that setting is process entire batches. So by default, it is checked. And what this means is a batch needs to be processed in entirety. If there's four images in the batch, all four must be verified and before they are exported. But if you click on or you uncheck process entire batches, that means if you've got a batch of four documents and the first two documents are need verification and the last two documents are good to go, essentially, pardon that writing here, then a batch will be split up. And so images one and two will be held for verification, and images three and four will be sent directly to export. Similarly, if you want to route files to different queues, you can route the entire batch if the process entire batch is clicked on. However, if you want to only send one document, then you want to, or just two documents in a batch, you want to make sure process entire batches is unchecked right there. We'll talk about data verification settings. So we'll be able to drill down a little bit here. By default, there's a 60% threshold level. If you want low confidence characters to be set at 40%, that means that there's a lower threshold. Those OCR engines only need to hit 40%. Or if you're more careful about your image threshold, then you can bump that up to 80%. Similarly, you can send files to group verification. That's when in data, usually in the data verification station, all like numbers are grouped together as we see here. And typically that's done for numbers only. And we can send to field verification always. That's essentially saying always verify a certain field. Double verification is allowed out of the box. And the same data is checked by two different operators. If there's a difference in the data, a third person adjudicates. And you can set up custom verification queues and then set up custom user roles with specific capabilities that point to those custom queues. That can be very handy and powerful. So we've got a number of errors, field errors, validation rules errors, such as sum calculations, database lookup errors, document assembly errors. We're going to look at that in a second. The order of pages is incorrect, or we're missing pages. And we can also have classification errors. So one thing we can do in the case that's pictured here is if there's images in the wrong order, or here we've got a page 2 of this document here coming after page 2 of this document here, we just need to drag that down and these rule violations will go away. These two numbers will line up and there'll be no errors. So it's often the case that you want to go into thumbnail mode to do some of these quality checks and error corrections. And finally, there's a web verification station that's very powerful and it's really requires no installation, so it's easy to deploy. You can use hotkeys. Operators can draw regions. You can work with complex regions. Operators can draw line items, can reanalyze line items. So most script rules are checked in the browser and standard rules are checked in the browser. So it's a very powerful environment. So once again, we've got 5 verification queues available to us. Out of the box, you can add more queues. A very large batch can be divided automatically into subtasks. And we've got some capabilities with data verification station, whether or not we want to do grouped verification and so forth. So pretty easy to configure these verification settings. Very, very powerful set of tools allowing you to make sure your data is clean before the data is exported.